Hi, I'm Swarupa Sail, course instructor for fluid mechanics. In this presentation, we will try to find out answers to the following questions, that is, why to find density, what is difference between heavy and more dense, what is difference between mass and density, what do we know by value of specific weight, and finally, why to find specific gravity. Coming to the first question, why to find density? It tells us how compact an object is in a given volume. It is used in identifying the type of mineral and rock since the density of a substance does not change much. For example, gold will always have density equal to 19.3 gram per centimeter cube. If a mineral has density less or more than 19.3, then it would mean that it is not a gold. Here the value of density is mentioned as 2.8 gram per cc. It would mean that it is a dolomite. In the second example, the value of density is given as 3.1, that means it is magnesite. So, we could come to know the type of mineral based on the value of density given. Density also helps us to determine the name and composition of a rock. In the first example, the density value ranges from 2.6 to 2.7 gram per cc. Based on this, we can know that it is marble and also its composition can be known. In the second one, density ranges from 2.8 to 2.9. We can very well know that it is basalt and also its composition can be known. Density is also used in oceanography, that is, some ocean currents and ocean circulation is controlled by knowing the value of density. Here in this picture, we can see that the rocks are being used along the coast to prevent erosion. To know in a better way, we will consider a problem. If a rock needs to weigh 2000 kilograms, in order not to be shifted by waves, how big does it need to be? That means here we are given the value of mass and with which we have to find its size, that is volume. To find out size, even we are given the value of density of basalt as 3200 kg per cubic meter. With all these three values, we will try to find out which is the equation which relates these three. Density is equal to mass upon volume will help us to find the size of the rock. So, volume is equal to mass divided by density. Mass is given as 2000 and density is 3200. With this, we get size of rock, that is volume, as 0.625 cubic meter. Hence, density helps us to determine the size of a ton of rocks of a given composition. In this slide also, we will try to check out why to find density. Density of object will help us to know whether a object will float or sink. Less dense substances will float on more dense substances. For example, we will consider a jar wherein two liquids are placed. First one is vegetable oil having density equal to 0.95 gram per milliliter, and second one is water which is at the bottom having density equal to 1 gram per milliliter. Since density of oil is less, compared to density of water, it will definitely float on water. We will consider some more examples. Why paper floats on water? Here there is a paper boat which is having less density compared to that of water, hence it will definitely float. Second one is, why do hot air balloons rise? When air is heated, it becomes less dense as molecules move apart, and hence it floats on denser and colder air. Third one is, why in a lake or ocean, water is warm at surface and cold at the bottom? The less dense water floats as it is warm on cold water, which is more dense. Finally, why volcanoes erupt? The magma is less dense, that is, it is having less density than the rocks which surround it. Hence, it rises to the surface. What is the difference between heavy and more dense? The words heavy and light refer to mass and not density. We will consider two problems wherein we are given the value of volume and mass. For the first rock, volume is 15 centimeter cube and mass is 45 gram. We are asked to find its density. And for the second one, volume is 30 cc, that is more than the first one, and mass is 60 gram, which is also more than the first one. We need to find its density. Apart from finding the value of density, we need to check out which rock is more heavy and which rock is more dense. To find out which rock is more heavy, we will compare mass of both the rocks. Mass of second is more compared to that of first, so 60 gram rock is heavy. And to find out answer for which rock is more dense, we need to find the value of density. We know that density is equal to mass by volume, that is 45 divided by 15 will give us the value as 3 gram per cc. Similarly, we will find density for second rock, that is mass by volume, which is nothing but 60 divided by 30 will give us the value as 2 gram per cc. Density for first one is 3 and for the second one is 2, with which we know that 45 gram rock is dense compared to 60 gram rock. Now we will find out what is the difference between heavy and more dense. Here there are two objects with same volume, but the number of molecules in first one is less compared to number of molecules in the second one. So that means second object is more dense compared to the first one. We will consider sponge which is less dense, that means it has low mass per unit volume and also it is very light. Hence, a large sponge is easy to lift as it is light. A very large sponge may weigh a lot, that is, it may have high mass, but its density is low, that means the molecules are away from each other. That means it weighs less per unit volume. For density, we consider size or volume of the object. If in case we consider iron, It is more dense and also is heavy. With this we conclude that sponges are less dense and are also light, whereas iron is dense and also heavy. Now we will find out the difference between mass and density. We know that density of water is equal to 1 gram per cc or 1000 kg per meter cube. For an object to float on water, it must have density less than 1 gram per cc. Consider a ship floating on water. For ship to float, density of ship should be less than density of water. But ship has large mass as it is made up of steel, but also it has large volume, that means its size is more. We know that density is inversely proportional to volume. Even though the size or volume of the ship is more, density is very less. Hence, density of ship is less than density of water. But ship sinks when density of ship is more than the density of water, that is when more mass is added onto it. What do we know by value of specific weight? Specific weight or weight density represents the force exerted by gravity on a unit volume of a fluid. For this reason, units are expressed as force per unit volume. Unit of force is Newton and unit of volume is meter cube. For example, water has specific weight equal to 9810 Newton per meter cube. We know that specific weight is equal to rho into g. Rho is density of water, which is nothing but 1000, and g is 9.81 meter per second square, that is acceleration due to gravity. Hence we get specific weight of water as 9810 Newton per cubic meter. Hence specific weight represents the force exerted by gravity on a unit volume of a fluid. Now we will try to check why to find specific gravity. We know that density of water is 1000 kg per cubic meter or 1 gram per centimeter cube. The specific gravity of an object will almost be same as that of density in gram per centimeter cube. That we will find out using this equation. We know that g is equal to density of fluid divided by density of water. We will substitute the value of density of water equal to 1 in this equation. So, we get specific gravity as equal to density of fluid. Hence, specific gravity is useful when comparing the density of two objects. We will consider two objects with specific gravity 2 and specific gravity 3, whereas density of first one is given in gram per cc and for the second one it is given in terms of kg per cc. We need to find out of these two objects which will be more denser. From this equation we have concluded that if we compare the value of g of two objects, we will come to know which is more denser. Since g for second object is 3 and for first is 2, second object is more denser. Even though the unit of g for the first one is in gram per cc and for the second one it is in terms of kg per cc, we could conclude which is more denser just based on the value of g, since g has no units. That is what is mentioned here. Since specific gravity is unitless, it doesn't matter whether the density was measured in gram per cc or in kg per cc. Specific gravity is a unitless number since it is the ratio of density to density. Its value will be same in metric system or any other measuring system. Even to avoid the problem of different units, many geologists use specific gravity instead of density. Thank you.